Lagos is one of the most congested cities in the world. 40% of cars in Nigeria are registered in Lagos. Commuters spend at least 3 hours in traffic each day. Apapa-Lagos route is one of the most congested. So bring a solution to Lagos traffic issues, an integrated transport system that links road, rail and waterways network is required. However, recurring boat mishaps in Lagos waterways, among other militating factors, have made waterway transportation somewhat unattractive to many. In recent time, rail transportation seems to be enjoying a new lease of life. As Lagos is constructing a light rail system, so also is the federal government rejuvenating the rail transportation across Nigeria. An example is Lagos-Ibadan Standard Gauge Railway.
Apart from moving people, it's used for moving massively freight, that is goods, either moving from the port or going to the port. And the impact of that, as I tell people, cannot just be quantified in terms of naira and copper. You have to be quantified, if you go on train, you have the peace of mind. And if you go on road, and because of the effective rail, you also have the peace of mind.
It's quite obvious that when the ongoing railway projects are fully completed and fully operational with COVID-19 out of the way, the seemingly intractable Lagos road congestion will be a thing of the past.
This train, the diesel multiple unit, has 8 coaches. The full capacity is 588 people in one move. But because of the COVID protocol, we've reduced our capacity to 338 in one move. If I take 338 people off Lagos-Ibadan Road, how many buses will I need to convey them? If my bus capacity is 20, if I'm doing 388 in one move, so 388 divided by 20, it gives me an idea of the number of buses we'll take off the road if we do COVID protocol. If I do 588, and I'm sure we'll soon start that because I think somehow we'll get over the COVID or whatever, vaccines and co, divided by 20. Again, it gives you the number of people we could take off the road. Don't also forget, the part of this project, which is an addendum, is the track that goes to Apapa Port and another addendum to Tinkan.
The expectations of many Lagosians for 2021 are simple.
I would expect that if we could have more train stations, because right now we have come all the way down to Ibuti Meta. So if you could have a rail system that could move within Lagos State itself, and you have stations people could board, say from Ikorodu down to the island, or Bega down to, you know, Festa, things like that.
I think the best that we have going on for Nigeria now is in the rail sector. I think so. The constructions going on here and there, I think that this is where we have the most hope for now, because traffic-wise, the roads, now it's not getting better.
Many of Nigerians that travel out, they know the best way of development is you provide transportation, whether inter or intra. Once you have it, development will go.
I really would like to see the ferry services extended, and I really would like to see the train services extended. I would like to see the road network in better condition. And I would like to see traffic management generally much better attended to.
If the waterways are safer, the Lagos roads less congested, and both the Lagos Light Rail and Nigeria Railway Standard Gauge services remain optimal and attractive, Nigeria will be on a quick way to economic prosperity.